to receive this recognition. And I also want to thank Councilman Jumani Williams. Let's give him a round of applause. And Councilwoman Lori Kumbo for this amazing, amazing event. Hats off to you. As I stand here this evening, I'm reminded of two things. The first is when I moved to New York City 16 years ago from a little town in North Carolina, I landed in Brooklyn. And my friend Nadine Gale, who's here tonight, allowed me to crash on her couch and a few other friends in Bed-Stuy. I was on Hancock between Lewis and Stuyvesant. And I finally landed an unpaid internship with Russell Simmons and later went on to do other things. And I just thank Brooklyn for just embracing me with open arms. You really just really treated me as family. And so that's why, again, I'm just so honored to be here. I'm also honored and truly impressed every day by my fellow honorees. First, I think about Shaka Pilgrim. And she doesn't know this, but when I entered the industry 16 years ago, I just admired her from afar. And I just had a girl crush. And so I just tip my hat to you for your consistency and being such a bright light in an industry that at times can be very dark. So hats off to you. And Tamika Mallory, my sister from another mister, who I call at 2 a.m. And she answered my calls and we cry together, we laugh together, and we get on the front lines together. This sister, and you all know this, is on the front lines, in the trenches, really doing the work. And so when the cameras shut down and the microphones go off, she's still there. And I think about character this evening, right? And too often we worry about reputation, but character is who you are when you walk away from the podium. And the life you live when the cameras aren't around. And so as I stand here this evening, I think of my second point, which is the unsung heroes and the women who will never receive a proclamation. I think about my grandmother, who we lost last year at 94 years old, who with no education, spent every Saturday morning in her kitchen teaching other women in her community how to read so they could pass literacy tests to just gain the right to vote. I think about my grandmother's sister, Aunt Mamie, who we're laying to rest this Friday in Washington, D.C., who spent 40 years as a public school teacher, but also as the primary caregiver of her disabled daughter until she passed away at 44. And so there are women like that in my life, and I'm sure in all of your lives, who are our unsung heroes, who will never receive the recognition they deserve, but who get up every morning and cook, who get up every morning and clean and provide, sometimes alone. And so I just say to all of you, don't forget about the women who don't receive the accolades. So I salute all of them and all of you for your hard work when the cameras aren't rolling. So thank you so much for this honor. Thank you so much for the invitation.